Clear the bed! It's time to show what I got for my birthday!
As per tradition.
Golf balls! Yes, strata, by the way. Obviously, these are more for a display than for playing, but they are pretty cool looking. To go along with the golf balls, I've also got a replacement flag for the outdoors, as my old flag and hole was really, really rusty and cracked up, and yeah, but since it's nighttime while I'm making this video, I can't exactly film it, but it's already installed outside, so yes. You'll probably see it in some future video, I'm sure. Poop the game! Yes, I have no idea how to play this, but there are two games in here, and well, I guess I'll be learning how to play Poop the Game. Insect repellents, because this is pretty much my clone in the summer times. I mean, the mosquitoes love to eat me alive, so it makes a lot of sense. The Mole Cube! It's basically like Sudoku with colors, but in Rubik's Cube form. I probably can solve it pretty quickly, though, but although maybe not, I don't know. Because, you know, we're going by getting different colors on each face, and yeah, if you don't have like a reference or something like that, it's a lot of logic figuring it out. So, yeah, it should be pretty interesting. Scube Extreme! Dream! Okay, I'll stop. So, if you don't know twisty puzzles, a scube is a puzzle that doesn't turn face-to-face, like, say, a Rubik's Cube. It's something that turns on corner axes. Well, I'll have to really show you to to get you the best idea here. So yeah, you don't turn it like this. No, you turn it like this. Yeah, see how it turns corner to corner, that sort of thing? Yeah, and I've solved a cube before. Like I said, I solved the Rubik's Cube before. I mean, as you probably know. And, well, I don't know how much more difficulty I'll have with this as opposed to a regular cube, especially since I haven't really messed around with it all that much, considering that I've got a lot of stuff for my birthday that I... Yeah, it's kind of hard to do everything at once, you know? Artificial time access! You might be wondering, what the heck is this? Well, this is a comic book by Raocow and AOD. Yeah, he actually does art and stuff like that, so I requested his book, and yes, it looks pretty dang awesome, but definitely not for kids. yeah, I've been watching raocow for ages, so I figured, I mean, even on DeviantArt and stuff like that, so I thought I would get something in print copy, because his work is just so awesome looking, and yeah, I can take a look-see through it at any time and whatnot. I'm not gonna page through everything and whatnot. If you wanna read the book, you can either go to the a.t.x.s website and whatnot to read it for yourself, or you can get a book off of Indie Planet, and that is what I have here. This is the first portion of the school arc, and it's pretty bulky here, so lots to read through, lots of artwork to admire. It will be good times. Pikagam, just get to the games. Hey, what makes you think I asked for games on my birthday? I might have given up gaming. Well, there is that pile of games over on the floor. Okay, I forgot you had eyes. No, come on! Alright, so I've been saving the games for last, really. Yes! Starting with Mario & Luigi Paper Jam for the Nintendo 3DS, or 2DS, really. I have not played this yet. It is still shrink-wrapped, as you can probably tell by the shininess all around it and whatnot, but we shall see how much I like it in the future, I suppose. one that I wasn't too sure about, but I thought I would give a try, is Shovel Knight. Yeah, it's the indie game now in physical form, and I decided to plop this one on my birthday list as it's cheap. And, well, it's getting pretty good reviews, though I'm really hoping that it's not Mega Man-ish in that you have to memorize a lot of things, as I heard the game is pretty hard, and when people say hard, it's usually something like memorize stuff, and yeah, you get what I'm saying. But I thought I would give it a shot anyway, because as I said, pretty cheap, so I'll see if I like it as well. As you can tell, it's still, yeah, shrink wrap too, so I haven't gotten around to playing it either. Klonoa 2 on the PlayStation 2. Yeah, remember Klonoa on the Wii? This is the sequel to it. Well, sorta. I mean, the Klonoa on the Wii is a Wii remake of the original Klonoa, and this is a sequel to it. So, yeah, I'll be able to play this bad boy. Yoo-hoo! Oh, it's used, so yeah, no shrink wrap this time. So, but I have not played it or opened it yet. Just, well, you know, other than the check inside to see if there's a, yeah, disc in there and whatnot, see its condition. So, yeah, otherwise, I did not play this. I expect it to be pretty good. Who knows? Maybe better than the first, or, well, remake that I played. Who knows? We'll see, I guess. Remember Fatal Frame random gameplay? Yeah, I got the sequel! Again, I have not played it despite it being open, because it is a used game as well, but it is checked over and whatnot to see its condition, and yep. I know I'm saying we'll see a lot here. Well, we'll see how much I like it. I mean, I've got a bunch of games, so yeah, it's impossible to play them all in one day, so yeah. Another sequel! Fatal Frame 3 The Tormented, the last in the trilogy before the whole localization shenanigan things, and yeah. So I thought, I'll get all the Fatal Frames that I can, hopefully, and see how they all are. Finally, the one game that I've played out of the whole bunch, Kirby Planet Robots. Yeah, I've been on kind of a Kirby kick lately with the Wii Kirby collection and whatnot, so it made sense for me to start out with this because, yeah, I've been, you know, Kirby kick and whatnot. It plays very well. It feels a lot like Kirby's Return to Dream Land and Triple Deluxe, as you would expect from the trailers and whatnot. But I would say it's a bit more puzzle-like in its design, thanks to said Robobots, because you're kind of switching between Kirby and said Robobots via a little, I guess you could say, hanger of sorts for said bots, and you need to kind of switch between being in that and being regular Kirby in order to make progress and whatnot. So it's a side-scroller platformer plus puzzle, and I like it. Though I haven't played all that much of it, I just like it so far. And that is all that I got for my birthday. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you later!